Hello students, welcome to your Kundu tutorial. Today we will be discussing about the cell chapter. We know that this is the fundamental unit of life. So it will be needed for your every classes, means from 6 to lifetime. Okay, in the NEET exam also from that cell chapter many questions they can ask, and in the higher studies also the cell. So you need to clear your concept about the cell, as because this is the fundamental and this is the mandatory unit of your life. Okay, so before going to start this session, those who have not subscribed my channel, please do subscribe and press the bell icon as usual to get that all notification from this channel, that Kundu tutorial, and be touch with this channel. Okay, so let's start the session, or whatever, if you have any queries or any problem in any topic and you want to discuss with me, obviously you give the comment in the comment section and do share the video and please like this video. Okay, so let's start this session. It will be quite different, so we will be discussing about the cell. So as you know before, the cell, it will be required from the lower class to the higher class. Means I am not telling about the classification, I am telling obviously about your classes. So as you know, from the CBSC learner or the CBSC students, obviously it will be needed from the class 6 only, it will be needed up to your lifetime. Inside your body, the cell is the basic structural and the functional unit. Okay, so each and every living organism, we need the cell, as well as the plant and the animals. Okay, not only plants and animals but also microbe need the cell. Okay, in other words, cell make up the living things and carry out the activities that keep in a living thing alive. So you are living, why? Because the cell it is having inside your body, and for that only you are alive and you can survive in the nature. Okay, you can survive against the nature, you can fight. Why? Because your cell is functioning, always it will active. Okay, so let's have a glance in the cell theory timeline. Actually, you know that Robert Hooke, we are telling, he is the discoverer of the cell. In the year of 1665, he observed actually the bark cell, you know, the bark cell, and where actually this bark is there in the stem of the plant. So from that bark cell, he took the cells, or he took the sample and he observed under the microscope, and this view actually it was like this scenario, and he termed it is as the cell. But in the year of 1674, one scientist, he was there, Anton van Leeuwenhoek, this scientist who gave the idea of the living cell. Why? Because that Robert Hooke discovered the cell, actually it was the cell wall, it was actually the cell wall, out covering of the cell, all these are the cell wall. What it is inside the cell, he didn't discover. Okay, so for that reason only A.V. Leeuwenhoek, this scientist, he observed the living cell. Okay, living cell means obviously other than the cell wall, inside the cell it is some living particle, it will be there, living particle it will be remains inside. Okay, next, who is there in the queue? 1883, there is lot of gap it was there, you know, from 1674 to 1883 there is huge gap it was there. Still Robert Brown, one scientist, he discovered that the nucleus, some prominent things it is there inside the nucleus, in the centermost portion, it is known as the nucleus, and he gave the name as the nucleus. Okay, next, who is there? Next is there Felix Dusserdin. Dusserdin, he discovered in the year of 1835 the cell is composed of some semi-liquid substances. Semi-liquid substances which he gave the term as the surcoat. As the surcoat. Okay, the surcoat actually it was replaced by the protoplast who gave this name. J.E. Perkin in the year of 1839. So this surcoat only it was converted into protoplasm by Perkin in the year of 1839. Just surcoat he gave the name, Dusardin gave the name surcoat as the living particle inside the cell, and just it was converted into protoplasm, just renamed actually in the year of 1839 by whom? By Perkin. Okay, next, the cell theory, it was there in 1838. Actually Sclaydin, he was botanist and he observed the cell inside the plant body, and he proposed that all the plant cells are made up of cells. After 1 year, 1839, Theodore Swan, one scientist, he was there just like friend of the Sclaydin, he proposed that all animals are made up of cells, just like that plant cell. So if you add to this statement, it will give the all living cells made up of only cells. So let's have a glance in the cell theory actually. Just now I told Sclaydin and Swan, they gave these two proposal. Okay. They gave these two proposal means all known living things are made up of one or more cell. More cell means multiple type of cell, multi-type cell, multi-type cell, just like us, we are the human being, and in case of the human being, many type of cells are there. So for example, digestive cells are there, digestive cell, suppose in case of the respiratory cell is there, okay, lung cell. So these are the all cells, this is known as actually the multi-type. But in case of the one cell, just like amoeba, this is the unicellular organism. Okay, and the point number three, the cell is the basic unit and of the structure and function in the living organism. That means the cell actually it is structural and as well as the functional unit. Why? With basic level of the organism and it will do the function, specific function. And last, this statement, all the living cells arise from the pre-existing cell, it was given by Rudolf Virchow. Rudolf Virchow told that all the cells, whatever you are seeing the cells, it is not the new cell. All it is having the pre-existing, that ancestral cell it is having. Okay. So guys, are you enjoying my classes? I know that some curiosity it is happening or it is coming in your mind, how the cell it is composed or whatever the cell it is having inside the intercellular spaces, right? So obviously in the next class we will be discussing whatever the cell theory, actually what is the cell theory. I will discuss about the cell components as well as the intracellular and the extracellular part. Okay, so don't forget to subscribe my channel and don't forget also to share my video, and please like my video and to support me to make such a video which will be helpful for you students. Okay, bye everyone, and thank you all of you. Have a good day.